Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys my filming setup. I get so many questions about what camera I use, what lighting, all of those things. So I figured why not show you guys all the equipment that I have and all the equipment that I use to film these videos. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with the lenses that I love to film with. This is my Canon zoom lens, 18 to 135. I love this lens because you can get a variety of things with this lens. You can get super up close and then you can get like a full body shot if you need it. I personally like to use this lens when I'm filming like my try-on hauls or things like that. I don't really use this lens much, but when I do my try-on hauls, this is the lens that I love to use. Moving on to the next lens, this is actually a lens that was recommended for one of my favorite YouTubers, Aaliyah's Face. I know you guys know her, she's freaking amazing. She recommended this lens to me. This is the 35mm Canon lens. I love this lens so much. This is the lens that I use to film all of my makeup tutorials. A fun fact about this lens, if you guys do decide to purchase it, this lens does not zoom in, it does not zoom out or anything like that. It is strictly a stationary lens, so if you do decide to buy this lens, you're gonna have to move your entire camera either forward or backward to get the angle that you're looking for. Moving right along to the next lens, I currently cannot show you guys the lens because I am using it to film with. It is the Canon 24mm lens, and fun fact about this lens, you guys, I actually used to use this lens to film my vlogs with. As you guys can see, you get such a big portion of your background, which is why I like this lens for vlogging. I also used to use this lens for like my try-on hauls and things like that. But it kind of got hard because you have to have the lens so far away because it doesn't really get like a super wide angle up and down, but it definitely gets a wide angle side to side. So if you want to get this lens, always just keep in mind that you do have to move your camera around to get the angle that you're looking for. Now that we've talked about all the lenses that I use, let's talk about what I use to vlog with. So as you guys know, I have been vlogging on my phone for years. I have never had a camera, but I did recently buy one, which I will talk about in a second. But this baby right here is my, what is this called? This is a Vimbel 25. It's like a knockoff of the gimbal. It's a stabilizer and I'm absolutely obsessed with it. I'm gonna turn it on for you guys so you guys can see how it works. So once you turn it on, this is how it works and it moves with you. I don't know if you guys can see that, but like it moves with you. So you get a very stable image or very stable video, and I love it. This thing was only like $100. I think it was like $109 or something like that, but it was definitely the best investment that I made for vlogging on my phone because vlogging on your phone, you know, your hand's shaky and you're moving around and you want your image to be stable. You want your viewer to be able to watch a very stable video. You don't want it to be super shaky. So that's why I love this. And I also love it because it acts as a tripod. So I can use it to take pictures on my phone. I can use it to like set it down, record and walk away, anything like that. And my image would be very stable. One of the main functions that I love about this, as you guys can see, it is giving me, hi, you guys see me right there? You guys, it's giving me a very, very, very clear image. I can change it in all different directions and it is very clear, very stable. It doesn't change, it doesn't move or anything like that. So I really love this because it really came in handy for me vlogging on my phone. It definitely changed the game for me. Moving on to the next piece of equipment that I have. It's a newer piece of equipment that I'm so excited to be trying out. I just purchased the Sony ZV-1 vlogging camera and the accessory kit. Fun fact that you guys should know, they do not come in a box together. It is completely sold separately, and I think it's almost like a $200 price difference. The vlogging camera on its own, I think was like $799, but with this, my total came up to like $950. So that is definitely something to note. You don't really need this. You can definitely just use your own tripod, but I wanted to get the full experience, so I purchased the entire package. A little bit about the tripod itself, it does take batteries, which I thought was so crazy. I thought it was like gonna be chargeable where you can recharge it, but it definitely does take a battery. And I thought that was kind of weird. I wish it was chargeable because now I have to worry about having batteries when in reality, I feel like this should have just been a chargeable situation. Like I feel like I shouldn't have to worry about putting batteries in here. It's kind of like if your camera had to have batteries instead of it charging. Like, I don't know, I just think that's weird. But yeah, I did just purchase this. I don't know much about it, so I can't really give you guys any full details about it. Comment down below if you guys want me to do a more in-depth video about my vlogging camera. Once I learn more about it, I can definitely film that for you guys.
All right, guys, so I do have Keith filming this for me. Say hey, girl.
Hey.
Okay, so I was gonna film this just on my own, but I really wanted to be in it and show you guys all the equipment. That way you guys can kind of get the full gist of everything. By the way, if you're watching this right now and you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button down below because your girl is trying to get to 100K by the end of the year and I cannot do it without your help. So we're gonna start off with my lighting equipment first. So this ring light right here, I just picked it up from Best Buy. It is nothing special. I love this ring light because, come stand over here, Keith, let me show them. Okay, I love this ring light because it can go from, you can use it from cool or warm light. So right now I like to use it on like a warm and a cool. mainly a warm light because I like for my ring light to pull on my skin warm, and then these lights, I like them to be super cool so they can get the background. That's a fun fact. If you guys did not know that, you guys should definitely be doing that so you are not washed out. Warm in the middle, cool on the outsides. But I love this ring light because it goes from super warm like this, which makes me look very, very yellow, all the way to super cool, which makes me look pale. So I do kind of like a middleman. Moving on to these lights that I have right here. I'm not sure of the name of them, but these are the newer lights that I picked up. They're the model NL660. I picked them up from Newer's website and I love them. You can either use a battery for it or you can just plug it in. And this also is dimmable, so it can go dim all the way to yellow, or it can be dimmed all the way to the cool setting. But I personally use it on the whitest of white and the coolest of cool because it's only lighting up my background and I want my background to look super white, super clean, super crisp. So like I said, I do have this newer light here, but I do have two of them and my other one sits over here. If you guys can't tell, they are actually sitting behind me for when I'm filming my videos. They are not doing anything for me personally, but they are doing all the work for lighting up my background and making my background look super white. So now that we have all my lighting out of the way, I'm gonna talk about my camera. First, I just wanna let you guys know this was not my first camera that I started YouTube with. I started with a Canon T6i. You do not need the most fancy, the most expensive equipment to do videos with. I'm currently filming on my phone right now. What is being used to film me is on my phone. So I just definitely wanna make it clear that you can use your phone to film videos. But my first camera that I started with on YouTube was a Canon T6i. And I think it was only like $500 or $600, so it wasn't super expensive at all. But this camera right here, this is my baby. It was recommended to me by Aaliyah's Face. If you guys have watched her video on her filming setup, she talked about this camera a lot. This is the Canon 80D. I've only had this camera for, again, about 7 months, so I'm definitely still learning about it, but this is the camera that I use to film all of my content on unless I'm vlogging. Moving on to my microphone, I absolutely love this microphone. This was my first microphone that I ever purchased, and it was such a great investment. And it wasn't even that expensive. I think the Rode mics are like, what, $150 or something like that? This one was only $200, so it wasn't super expensive at all. But this is the Zoom H4n Pro, and I love this. But the thing that I don't like about it is the fact that it takes batteries. Like, I'm just confused with these things needing to take batteries. It bothers me. But yeah, it takes batteries, and it does have a separate SIM card in here. So you need to have your SIM card in here at all times when you're filming, and then you just plug it into your computer and match the sound up with your camera, which kind of sucks, but at the same time, it's worth it because your audio is stellar. So now I'm gonna show you guys my monitor and how I see myself when I'm filming. I get so many questions on this. Every time I post an Instagram story about my monitor, people are like, how do you do that? What'd you do? I need to know. So I'm gonna show you guys right now. So what I do is I turn my camera on, and once it turns on, you see it's gonna link to my computer. So then I'm gonna come over here to my computer, and I'm gonna connect it. So you can get, the way that I have it connected, you have to go to canon.com and connect it. It has like a little system that you download and it connects for you. So I'm just gonna turn it on, shoot live, and I'm gonna sit here. So this is basically how I film my videos. I get to see myself, I get to see everything. It shows when I record, when I stop recording, all of that stuff. It's so great. It's such a good little investment, and I think it's free, actually. I didn't pay for it, but if you don't have a monitor and you have a computer, definitely worth it. All right, you guys, so now that I have showed you guys all of my filming equipment, I actually wanna show you guys how I have it all positioned and set up. So as you guys can see here, I have a ring light in the middle. I have my two lights on the side over there, and then I have another tripod with my camera in the back. I have a clear chair, which works perfect because you don't see it in my videos. So I highly recommend getting a clear chair or a chair that doesn't really have a backing so you can't see it in your videos.